Hey everyone, it's Jacqueline at Pixie Dust PhD. Today we are going to do another Disney Vacation Club behind the scenes video and take a peek at 7-month availability in May of 2023. If you're new to the channel, this is not the first video in the series. We've also looked at 7-month availability in September of 2022, December of 2022, and March of 2023. I will leave links to those videos in the description below for you to check out. And if you find this type of content helpful, please be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. You can then ring the bell icon to receive notifications whenever I post new videos. I really appreciate your interactions with the channel and sharing the content with your friends. As with all the other videos in the series, I want to make the quick disclaimer that what you're about to see is only one slice in time. This may not be generally applicable and trends may not hold true. Disney Vacation Club availability does change frequently, day to day, even hour by hour. Again, this is only one slice in time. We will focus on 7-month availability. This is when Disney Vacation Club opens up to all members. At 7 months, you do not have to own a home resort contract to book that location. But by virtue of the platform, you will also get to see 6 months and 8 months. 8 months then is into home resort owner priority. And occasionally, we will also probably look at sooner timeframes like 5 months and sometimes further into the home resort priority window at 9 months or more. Based on prior viewer feedback, we'll continue to do this for Walt Disney World, Disney Vacation Club resorts only. We will not be looking at DVC resorts outside of the Walt Disney World area. And notably, I am a resale member after certain restrictions were put into place, so I cannot see the Riviera Resort booking. However, big shout out to awesome friend of the channel, Peter, who will often leave the Riviera availability down in the comments below. So you can look for Peter's comment and please say thank you. I am taking this on October 14th, 2022. That means 7-month availability begins on Sunday, May 14th, 2023. For the 2023 points charts, May 1st through 14th is in the second cheapest travel period, but then for May 15th through June 10th, you'll see the point cost jump a bit as this is in the third cheapest travel period, so it will cost a little bit more. But overall, there are 7 travel periods for 2023, meaning that the month of May actually isn't that expensive, generally speaking. Specifically, I'm going to request the dates of May 14th through May 21st, 2023. This is a full week vacation. We'll look at all room types, and again, we will just focus on home resorts at Walt Disney World. I have a Bay Lake Tower home resort contract, so that is what will pop up first. You can see there will be some refurbishments in January through April of 2023, but we are looking at May. So right now, 7 months in advance, most things are available, actually. You have your Lakeview Studios, very available. Let's look back into March. Okay, March is super not available, but April onwards, quite available. Your one-bedroom Lakeview Villa, 100% available at 7 months and 6 months. Wow, even most of March is available. Basically none of February, though. Again, it's October right now, so February is only 4 months away. Theme Park View one-bedroom villa, very available at 7 months and 6 months. 5 months, not as much. Now we're into two bedrooms. This is the Lockoff Lakeview Villa. Again, super available. A few dates taken in April and May. March is super booked though. Two bedroom Lakeview Villa. This is the standard, not the Lockoff. Similar story here. There's a few dates gone in April. That's about it. And there's even a full week left in March here. Now we're at the Theme Park View two bedroom villa, dedicated, not a Lockoff. April 12th and 13th are taken. And March is pretty patchy, but yeah, if you can book this 6 months out or even 5.5 months out, pretty available. And even the three-bedroom Lakeview Villa is available. A few more dates taken, but largely this would be pretty easy to snag. So let's look at what's only partially available. The Theme Park View Deluxe Studio. So starting at Home Resort Priority tomorrow is available, but you wouldn't be able to book it today. First half of May is gone. April's patchy, but there are long stretches in here for sure. March is totally booked though. The Lockoff two bedroom with a Theme Park View is basically the same story as the Deluxe Theme Park View, which makes sense since it's a Lockoff. The Theme Park View three bedroom Grand Villa is pretty available, honestly, just not for exactly 7 months from today on May 14th. But if you wanted to go in April, you still could. The dedicated two bedroom standard view is, yeah, I mean, you've got this first week of May, that looks pretty good. April's quite taken, though. I'm guessing these are folks who want the two-bedroom but also want to save some points in the standard view. Reminder, May 15th onward is all in home resort owner priority, so look at June, for example, is even probably more than half taken. July is quite taken. August is pretty taken. If you want this two-bedroom villa standard view at Bay Lake Tower, you might want a home resort contract. Here we have the one-bedroom. It's not quite as sparse as the two-bedroom. Yeah, July and August look much better than the two-bedroom, in fact. but definitely fairly in demand. But you could book 3 nights right now, May 14th, 15th, and 16th at the 7-month booking window. Just May 17th and 18th are taken, so you'd have to do a split stay or go on the wait list. And the deluxe standard view studios, rough. You have April 24th through 29th, actually. But nothing in March, very little in May or June. July and August look better. Standard views at Bay Lake Tower if you want to save some points, but still walk to Magic Kingdom. I think you'll want a home resort contract. And here's the 2-bedroom lock-off standard view, so it's going to mirror what we've been looking at again. It's just super booked. Next up, we have Saratoga Springs Resort, so quite a lot of please pardon our pixie dust text here. There's refurbishments October through December of 2022. And then moving into 2023, there's January through late March. Pool refurbishment, but it looks like May you'd be fine. So these are all fully available. Got studio, 1-bedroom, 2-bedrooms, treehouse villas, 3-bedrooms. Everything is actually fully available. There's not a single room type that isn't fully available for the week we asked for. Here's the deluxe studio. May is 100% available. All of March is available. All but one night in April is available. February is more than half available. January starts to look a little more dicey. And this is the deluxe studio preferred room. 100% available April, May, June. Let's go backwards in time. Just a couple nights in January. February is half available though, so should be pretty easy to book Saratoga. Here's the standard 1-bedroom villa. April, May, June, again, totally available. March is totally available. February is almost totally available. And the January availability here is much better than the studios. And your 1-bedroom preferred villa, same trends. Pretty easy to book Saratoga. Let's go even further back just for fun. It's currently October. So you could go right before Thanksgiving, American Thanksgiving, I believe, November 21 through 23. Otherwise patchy in the 3 months out time frame. But 4.5 or more months, I mean, you can book this room. Now we've got the 2-bedroom lock-off standard. All but one night in April is available, so you can't stay here April 14th. March is up for grabs. February is about half booked. January starts to look patchier. Here's the 2-bedroom dedicated standard. Again, just super available. Saratoga Springs has a lot of inventory, and I think you can tell based on the availability. In the 2-bedroom lock-off, this is preferred, not standard. Again, really extremely available until you get to February, and even February is decent. And then January is when things start to look a little worse. Here's the 2-bedroom villa that's a preferred room. Just extremely bookable. Oh, you could even still stay Christmas Eve. Treehouse villas, April, May, and June, any day you want. March, for the most part, more than half of February, parts of January. Again, Christmas Eve, that's fun. And here's the standard 3-bedroom grand villa. Almost fully available in February, not quite. But yeah, you don't start to hit worse availability till January, really. And the preferred 3-bedroom grand villa, totally open April, May, June. March, there's one date you can't stay. February is probably more than 2/3 of the month. January's a little patchier. Generally speaking, if you're able to plan more than 4 or 5 months in advance, you can probably get a room at Saratoga Springs. Next up, we have Disney's Animal Kingdom Villas at Kidani Village. So all of these are also fully available. There's not a single room type that you can't book. Starting with the Standard View Deluxe Studio, you have this full week in May. The first half of May, there is about a week taken here, but April's still quite available. Second half of March is fine. Before that, it gets harder. The deluxe studio with the Savannah view, May is totally available, almost all of April, back half of March, and then, yeah, early March, February, January is pretty spotty. Moving on to the standard view 1-bedroom villa, 100% available April, May, and June. March is mostly available with the exception of the 13th through the 15th. February is a little harder, but you do have a week-long stretch here, the 11th through the 17th, just a couple nights here and there in January. The Savannah View 1-bedroom villa is totally available April, May, and June. March is almost fully available. February is about half. January is pretty patchy. Yeah, nothing in November or December. Now we're at the lock-off 2-bedroom standard view villa. This is a lock-off, so unsurprisingly, the same time frame in early May is taken. But April looks good, back half of March. Not too hard to book this room if you can plan 5-6 months in advance. Here's your dedicated two-bedroom villa with a standard view. Couple dates taken in May and April, but largely quite available. Same with March. February gets a little dicier. The two-bedroom lock-off villa with the Savannah view, quite available. If you can book this 5 months out or more, it should be probably okay. Here's the dedicated two-bedroom villa with the Savannah view. It's totally bookable all of April, May, almost all of March. Just once you hit February, January, that starts to get harder. For the three-bedroom grand villas with a standard view, it is totally available when we're asking to book, but patch your availability in early May, a couple of dates in April booked. Peak March is booked, but otherwise looks okay. February and January, though, you could only get a couple nights in a row. And if you wanted a Savannah view for your three-bedroom grand villa, pretty close to the same story, actually. It's fairly available. A couple nights in May and April are booked. Again, peak mid-March. I'm guessing this is spring break for a lot of people is taken, but otherwise fine. February gets harder. Almost nothing left in January. Next, we have Copper Creek Villas and Cabins, and actually every room type is fully available for the dates we requested 7 months in advance. I am so accustomed to Copper Creek being fully booked because the inventory is so low, I guess people are staying elsewhere these days, maybe? Also, considering that borrowing is back to 100%, I assume this means that the point backlog from the closure is now not nearly as much of a problem. So I became a member during pandemic times. I've only been used to that level of availability. Maybe this is closer to what things were like before there was that huge points backlog. But anyway, you could stay this full week in the Copper Creek Deluxe Studio. And actually, the first week of May is pretty much available, back half of April. But if you're not planning further ahead, then yeah, it gets rough. March is fully taken. There's only one date available in February, nothing in January. If you wanted the deluxe studio with a walk-in shower instead of the shower tub combo, that's also pretty dang available. Definitely this first part of May, so close to the 7 month mark. April's rougher, but you can get 4 nights in a row. About a week left in March, and that's basically it. For the one bedroom villa at Copper Creek, May is available, almost all of April is available. Maybe about half of March, but there are some good long stretches together where you wouldn't have to do a split stay if you didn't want to. But nothing in December, January, and only 3 dates in February. Got the two bedroom lock-off villa. This should be mirroring basically the deluxe studio availability, I would guess. And yeah, you've got, you know, most of the first chunk of May, a couple dates missing, about half of April. Nothing in March, one date in February, nothing in January. And the two-bedroom lock-off with a walk-in shower, so this should mirror the deluxe studio with the walk-in shower availability. May's okay. Gets a little harder April, March. There are some dates, though, which genuinely I'm used to this being kind of nothing all the time. Here we have the dedicated two-bedroom villa. The back half of April is totally open, and a good portion of the front half of May. And there's still even this week available in March from the 18th to the 24th. This is not that bad. Okay, here we have the cabins. I am used to these being open because they do cost a lot of points. So you can see, fully bookable, May and April and March, most of February. And just once you get into January, things change. And finally, the three-bedroom grand villa. May 2nd through 7th is taken, but you've got the 1st and then the 8th through the 14th through today. Almost all of April is available. Bits here and there in February and March, single days in January. But overall, at least in my naive opinion, I'd say this is really good availability for Copper Creek. Next, we have Old Key West Resort. Typically, most of these rooms are available. Again, there's just a very large inventory here. And yep, offerings near the hospitality house are not fully available for all of my requested dates. So if you do want to be near the hospitality house, you probably do want to jump on that right away when booking for the 7 month period opens up or get a home contract. But otherwise, if you're not picky about where you'll be, you can probably get a room here. So for the deluxe studios, there's one date in May and one date in April that is fully booked, one date in March. February and January is a different story. One bedroom villas, totally available May and April and March. February and January looks better than the studios for sure, but it's going to be hard to string a full stay together. I mean, there's 6 nights here in January and, you know, 4 nights here in February, but if you're staying for a full week or more, this would probably be a split stay situation. Oh, the one-bedroom villa near the hospitality house is fully available for the dates I selected, so that's nice. And actually, in general, this is not bad. I'm not sure what the inventory breakdown of near hospitality house versus not is. I assume there's not nearly as much near the hospitality house, but maybe there's a decent amount of one-bedrooms. Because you could even stay for quite a while in March. And here we have the two-bedroom villa near the hospitality house. Pretty similar story to the one-bedroom we just looked at. Quite available April and May. Fairly available March. Even February is not too bad here. Here is the two-bedroom lock-off. Very available. This is going to mirror the deluxe studio availability. This is the dedicated two-bedroom. Totally available March, April, May. Most of February even. This is the three-bedroom Grand Villa Standard. Available for when we asked for, and most of prior to then, really through mid-April. Much prior to mid-April though, and it's definitely patchy, would be harder to book a longer stay. And these next three room types are those that are not fully available for our requested stays. This is the deluxe studio near the hospitality house, and this is very close. 7 months from today is not available, so once you move into home resort owner priority, it's available, but today was the trick here. But if I had logged on and looked at this, you know, right when things opened up, this may be a different story, because you can look at the back half of April and it's open. Though points cost in April is significantly higher than the points cost in May, as you can see. Couple weekends in March here and other random days, a bit in February, nothing in January or December. For the two-bedroom lock-off near the hospitality house, it's the same story as what we just looked at for the deluxe studio near the hospitality house. No surprises there. And here's the three-bedroom Grand Villa near the hospitality house. This is quite booked. I suppose if people are going to spend enough points to get a Grand Villa, they would rather be near the hospitality house than not. But overall, booking Old Key West shouldn't be too challenging for you. Next is the villas at Disney's Grand Floridian Resort. First up, we have the Resort Studio Standard View. This is the converted hotel rooms, not the deluxe studio. So that's available for when we asked, but the first half of May is taken, but the latter half of April is pretty open. March is okay, it's not great, and then things start to get worse from there. This is the Resort Studio Lagoon View, so again, the hotel room-esque studios. This is not too bad, really, overall. Pretty good availability here, even in March. And here's your Theme Park View Resort Studio. Again, pretty available, honestly. If you can plan this 5 months out, you can probably get a room. That's exciting. This is a one-bedroom villa standard view, so fine for when we asked, but the first part of May is not nearly as available. Again, back half of April looks good. Patchier before then. And the Lakeview one-bedroom villa, largely the same story. And here we have the two-bedroom Lakeview. Similar, like back half of April looks good, first half of May looks tougher. Seems like you'd want to be on this right when the 7 month window opens up if you don't have a home resort contract. Now let's look at the rooms that were not fully available. Here's the standard view two bedroom. That's not that bad, honestly. Back half of April, I mean, if you have the points to spend and you don't want to plan super far in advance, seems like an okay time to target. Here's the standard deluxe studio, so what you think of as the DVC deluxe studio, not the converted hotel rooms with the lake view. Again, back half of April. It's first chunk of May, I guess because it is one of the cheaper times to travel for DVC. Here we have the two-bedroom lock-off villa with a lake view. Yeah, this would be harder to book. This is your standard view deluxe studio. Definitely worse availability than most of the other rooms, but overall it's still not terrible. Like, you still could stay for a whole week in the back half of April. In the two-bedroom lock-off villa standard view, this should look similar to the studio we just looked at. And yep, same story here. Back half of April. And finally is the three-bedroom grand villa with the lake view. This is actually fairly available, just not for right when we were asking for. But that's not terrible. And if we look into home resort owner priority, it's open. So if you definitely want to snag a three bedroom, the home resort contract will work for you. Next, we have the boardwalk villas. There is going to be some January refurbishments to the Skyliner and nothing else announced at the moment, but we are expecting boardwalk to undergo its refurb sometime soon, I hope. So fully available is the Garden or Pool View Deluxe Studio, right when we asked at 7 months, but again, early May, not so much. Back half of April again looks fine. nothing January, February, one night in March. Boardwalk is very popular. Here's the standard view one bedroom villa. Basically the same story as we've been seeing. This is the Boardwalk View one bedroom villa. I'm a little surprised to see this available. That's cool. Yeah, and even this first week of April, but much before that, it's not so good. So I wouldn't delay more than about 6 months. Honestly, in general, if you can plan ahead and book right at 7 months, that's what I would always advise. The Gardner Pool View one bedroom villa is very available. This is fairly expected in my opinion because inventory is large, at least compared to other room types. And here's the two bedroom lock off with a Gardner Pool View. Mirroring the Gardner Pool View other offerings we've seen makes sense. Okay, what is not fully available? The three bedroom grand villa with a boardwalk view, that makes sense to me. You can get, you know, a few nights here and there, but a full week is a lot to ask for without a home resort contract for grand villas usually. The Standard View Deluxe Studio, this is the cheapest offering. This room often is sold out at 7 months in advance. This is definitely something I would plan to be on the waitlist for. Probably book Saratoga Springs or Old Key West or something similar, and then go on the waitlist. Or get a home resort contract. And because of the studio availability, then your two-bedroom lock-off Standard View is similarly pretty bad. Here's the Boardwalk View Deluxe Studio. Pretty taken. Very popular. And then, of course, the two-bedroom lock-off Boardwalk Views is going to be the same as the Deluxe Studio. So if you want to save some points on the Standard View or you want the limited inventory Boardwalk View, you really want to be super on top of this. You may even want a home resort contract. Next, we have the Animal Kingdom Villas on the Jumbo House side of things. So I'm expecting the value rooms and the club concierge rooms will be fully booked. Otherwise, there should be okay availability here. So you can stay in a deluxe studio with a Savannah View. Back half of April is open. The week we requested in May is open. There's a few dates in early May that are taken. Let's look a bit earlier. Oh, much before April's pretty bad though. Here's the one bedroom villa with a Standard View. May is totally open. April's almost fully open. March is very available. February, there's some nights, not too many. And then January, just these two. This is the Savannah View one bedroom. April looks very good and the first part of May is fully open. But once you get to March, it starts to get a little harder for sure. And the two bedroom lock off Savannah View. Not too bad. Not fantastic. If you can plan 6 months in advance, it'll probably work out. All right, so what is not available? The three bedroom grand villa with the Savannah View is available beginning with home resort priority, so just today. So if you logged on this morning right when it opened up, this might have worked out for you. It's hard for me to say. But the back half of April with that higher points cost is fine. Some strings of days in March and a little bit in late February even. For the Standard View Deluxe Studio, interestingly, it's Monday, May 15th that's the problem. 7 months from today is open, and then the rest of the time, but this Monday was taken presumably by home resort owners. But 6 months out, it looks okay. It's really before that that's not as good. Here's the two-bedroom lock-off Standard View Villa. This will mirror the Deluxe Standard View since it's a lock-off. And yep, now's all of the value and club concierge level accommodation. So let's go look at home resort priority for these even. This is the one bedroom value. July would be okay. That's like 9 months or so. Here's the studio value. July is fully booked. August only has two dates available. It's just booked. You need home resort priority for this room. And then here's the two bedroom value. It should be pretty booked. Yep, same as the deluxe studio. Now let's go back and look at club level. Here's the one bedroom club level. If you have a home resort contract, there's these four dates in June. Oh, and July and August aren't bad. This is not as bad as the value rooms. Here's the deluxe studio club level. I'm guessing this will be very booked. Yep, because this is the cheapest club level room you can get. You need a home resort contract for this. And then the two bedroom club level should be like the deluxe studio. Yep. So if you really want to stay club or value, I would definitely suggest you get a home resort contract. Otherwise, if you're booking 7 months out, even 6 months out in many cases, you'll probably be okay. Next up, we have Boulder Ridge Villas. Interestingly, there is no real partner Pixie Dust text here, even though we know it's currently undergoing refurb. Refurb might be done by this May timeframe though, but we know that the timeframe we're asking to book does not really affect the text that we're shown. Okay, so this is fully available. Interesting. I'm also used to this being more like Copper Creek, where it's harder to book. So the week we asked for, May 14th through 20th, is fine. Much before that, in early May, you can get a few nights, but not a full week together. Latter half of April looks good. Some nights in March, it's not terrible. One night in January, one night in February. Oh, for the one-bedroom villa, you're totally available in May and April. Almost all of March. Nothing in February, though. I believe early March would be like 4.5 months out. So if you can plan 5 months out, maybe you can snag this one-bedroom. Next is the two-bedroom lock-off, so it should look like the deluxe studio availability. Yep. And then the two-bedroom dedicated, quite available. Almost all of April, the back half of March. So again, if you can plan in advance at least 5 or so months, this will probably work out. Next we have the Polynesian, and all of the rooms are fully available. So this is the standard view deluxe studio, available for the dates we requested at 7 months. And the day that is 7 months minus one day is also available, May 13th. But you can see the rest of early May is pretty much taken. Most of April is available. A good portion of March is available. Not so much before that. Next up is the Lakeview Deluxe Studio. Fairly similar story. It's a little more available than the standard view in May. But yeah, March looks pretty bad. And then the bungalows, which are typically quite available. Yep. Not a problem to book a bungalow 7 months out. And our last resort is Beach Club. You can see the only room that's fully available for our dates is the one-bedroom villa. Early May doesn't look great. April is pretty bad. You can get these 3 nights at the end of April together, but otherwise nothing more than that in a row. Single dates in March, nothing in February, nothing in January. Beach Club is very popular. Okay, here's the two-bedroom villa, which is available for 5 of our requested nights, but not 7 months from today on May 14th. So this is all into home resort owner priority time. For what you could book as a non-home resort owner is Saturday, May 13th, or these 2 days in April. That's it. Now for the deluxe studio, there's only 2 nights available, and they're way into the home resort owner priority period. So nothing in May, 2 nights in April, 1 night in March, nothing in February, nothing in January. And the two-bedroom lock-off should basically look the same. Yep. So let's move into the future to look at home resort priority here. So that would start May 15th. So even 7 months plus 1 day is not good. If you have home resort priority, you don't want to leave it till the very last minute. But June and July and August are all fully open. Almost all of the home resort priority ownership is open, just not really, really soon to that 7 month mark. And then also this weekend in May. This might be a Memorial Day weekend in the US, that's kind of why I'm thinking that would be booked out a little further in advance. Overall, I would say this is actually pretty good availability for that mid-May timeframe, and definitely if you were willing to spend more points, it looked like the latter half of April was fairly easy to book across most of the resorts. If this is when you typically travel, I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions, leave those in the comments down below and I'll definitely get back to you. Thanks to all the lovelies who've liked the video and subscribed to the channel, I super appreciate it. I hope the rest of your day is magical, and we'll see you real soon at Pixie Dust PhD.